detonate by pressing the aim down sights button. The target is then caught on fire and will continue to take damage until the target dies. The overdrive mode, on the other hand, is actually more like how you might expect this weapon to work, in that it functions.
No fucking hit mark, are you serious?
Where once you fire, the darts explode on impact, dealing damage in addition to potentially burning enemies that manage to survive that initial blast. Because of the overdrive mode, I tend to prefer upgrades that boost the firestorm's spam potential. So things like speedy reload and rapid fire might be good here, as you can more quickly get overdriven shots off. At the same time, I sort of have mixed feelings about the firestorm overall. This is because I feel like this weapon is hard to use, and even after upgrades, I always feel like I'm expending a tremendous amount of ammo to take down enemies. The overdrive is good, but it's difficult to build up overdrive with this thing, since you're always waiting for enemies to succumb to the fire damage that you've dealt. If they don't, you have to go back and then try again in order for that to occur. If you want this thing, it's located at the dank catacombs arc that's located in the
central wetlands. I can't fucking do
it. No, I'm not playing Rage 2, I'm playing Fortnite. I'm playing solos, bro. I'm not.
Well, I can't build.
Though it's not especially effective against bosses or any other really big enemies, the grab dart launcher is a fucking amazing weapon that the player can use to place their opponents around.
Oh my god, yo.
Allows the player to shoot gravity darts into the enemy while pressing the aim down sight button, fires another dart that
really
sends the gravity into a specific area, sending enemies flying to that specific area. The strength of the gravitational pull
button
is
again
determined by the number of darts you fire at the enemy, and the stronger the pull, the faster the enemies are moving, which means the more likely the enemy dies. For upgrades, I'd recommend homing primers, the mag size upgrade, and the rapid fire and weapons mastery upgrade, as the former three are going to be good to make the weapon easier to use.
I missed the P90.
The weapons mastery allows for detonation upon impact.
Fucking serious,
which makes it so that whatever gets pulled.
Let the Baba Yaga get a break. Let the Baba Yaga get a break, please.
Earlier, this thing is sort of limited in that it works best against regular sized enemies.
Try that here for the Baba Yaga. I think it's a lot of fun
to use. Yeah, look.
Bitch, I'm gonna come over here with that weak jump, nigga. Bye bye, nigga.
Through the game, and that's the Ranger Assault Rifle. Like the Sidewinder, the Ranger Assault Rifle is acquired at the very beginning of the game. Unlike many of the other weapons in this game,
yeah,
which have a unique bolt fire mode while aiming down sights, the Ranger Assault Rifle is
pretty standard
in that its performance is consistent during both hip fire and aiming down sights. Personally, I prefer this to the Sidewinder's dual modes, as the burst fire can be a little bit unwieldy without recoil reduction. That and the full auto nature of
this
the Ranger
Rifle popcorn,
makes it easier to use, where I always feel like I'm constantly worried about missing with the Sidewinder. Upgrade-wise, I also think the Ranger Assault Rifle also has a bit more potential than the Sidewinder, as it's capable of sporting greater base damage after the Armor Breaker upgrade.
Oh, you can where
have
are
a size of 52 after upgrades as well, which is another advantage. This is also an aside, but you can also carry double the assault rifle ammo compared to the ammo. So that's just another advantage, even though it's not really an upgrade per se.
Yeah, this is why I nigga don't eat popcorn.
I've used this gun pretty much throughout the entire game, and during the best
bitch, you shot at the Baba Yaga? Are you serious? Are you on drugs?
So if you're having a tough time picking,
lay off the drugs, man. Shooting at the Baba Yaga, man.
Rifle, even if it's a little generic by Rage 2 standards. Moving on from the generic, we have the very first dark weapon that you usually obtain in this game, and that is the combat shotgun. Now, in order to obtain this thing, you'll need to do the blackout mission that you complete for Marshall and Gun Barrel. So, really, as long as you go to Gun Barrel at the very beginning of the game, and you meet Marshall and complete this quest, you should get the combat shotgun. Functionally, the combat shotgun has a pretty standard run-of-the-mill hip fire and functions like you might expect. However, it has a special bolt fire mode that allows the player to fire slugs that can knock enemies down while engaging in fights. There's also a unique overdrive mode where the player's shotgun pellets gain some penetration potential, allowing them to pass through targets and hit enemies behind them. So, as you can imagine, this makes the shotgun very useful for taking on mobs.
What happened to my Mexican?
I'd highly recommend the speed loader, because it greatly improves reloading. Far shot can improve your range a little bit, and after that, it just makes sense to pick up the and weapon masteries to further improve the shotgun's capabilities. Overall, though, I'd say this is a great gun and will likely be one of the main weapons you use throughout your playthrough. So be sure to upgrade it and improve its capabilities as soon as you're able. Now, this next entry might be controversial, but in fourth place, we have the BFG 9000. A popular weapon from the Doom franchise by id.
I'm a ride till I can't no more. Gonna take my horse to the town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. Gonna horse to the town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. Hats down, hats down, living like a rock star.
Alright, y'all.
The funniest thing. Oh, you finna go? Why? Tell them to get on.
Yup. Hold on.
This nigga really trying to try hard. Fuck off here. I showed it to you. Could have sworn. Chill, yo. Fuck off me, nigga. I tried to tell you, chill.
Much better off with using other similar heavy weapons that have cheaper ammo or are just more practical to operate. In the end, if you didn't get the special editions, I wouldn't worry about it too much. If you did get the special editions, though, simply drive out of Vineland at the very beginning of the game and you should find it from a fallen meteorite. Here's the map location if you missed it. Coming in at number 3 for the bronze, we have the Hyper Cannon. So this thing is effectively the game's sniper rifle, and functionally, its damage can be charged up provided you use the alt mode, which, interestingly, gives the weapon a bit of penetration potential, allowing the projectiles to pass through enemies and hit enemies behind them. Personally, I think this weapon is usually better off being something you lead off with in a fight on an unaware enemy, rather than as a primary weapon for combat. The damage is really high against the right enemies, but I think it's limited somewhat against heavily armored enemies like the Shrouded, and functions better in that case as a means of stripping armor. Upgrade-wise, I'd recommend the Armor Breaker Shockwave, the cartridge capacity for improved magazine size, and charge efficiency so you can get your charged shots to charge much faster. Despite the high ranking I've given this thing, the Hyper Cannon is not really one of my favorites. That said, it's a good gun and can be useful in taking down authority sentries, so if you want it, it's acquired from the Green
Guard. I need to ship by the Baba Yaga. Josh, no, man.
I'll showcase the map here on screen so you can find it. Just be aware that the enemies here are really tough, so make sure you're prepared before coming here. Coming in at second place for the silver, we have the Smart Launcher. In my humble opinion, the Smart Rocket Launcher is very powerful and is very fun to use. For the standard hipfire, you shoot a single rocket like normal, however, provided you aim down sight and use the alt mode, it has a lock-on feature that allows you to fire a cluster of missiles at locked-on targets. It also has a unique overdrive mode, which allows the player to take advantage of firing this cluster of missiles while hip-firing, and given the slight firing boost
heavy left sleep.
Overdrive, this can prove to be especially
deadly.
As far as upgrades go, I usually choose multi-targeting, quick lock, and then I go for the mag size boost. I don't think you'll need another multi-targeting upgrade, and you may find that speedy reload isn't really that necessary. Also, you can pick up the weapon mastery if you want, but you may find that the remote detonation is more or less useful depending on your playstyle. In practice, I found this thing tends to be a bit weaker than the weapon that takes the gold for this video. However, make no mistake that the Smart Launcher is still a very good weapon and makes short work of most enemies. Want it, it's located at the strongbox arc that's located in the Torn Plains, and I'll show a picture of it on the map here so you can more easily find it. And for the gold, and at number one, we have the charged pulse cannon. Maybe it's personal preference,
oh my God,
the charged pulse
cannon
is the best gun in the game. This mainly comes down to how its ammo is relatively common and cheap, and the weapon itself possesses a pretty high damage value, only really being surpassed by the shotgun, which has lower range, and the BFG, which has really expensive ammo. Functionally, the charged pulse cannon has to be heated up through some sustained fire to maximize its damage potential. As you can see from some of the gameplay, there's a small yellow and larger red bar, and the goal here is to try and stay within the red sweet spot, using the ADS button slash key to cool down the gun so you don't overheat and have to wait a few seconds before you can start firing again. Providing the overdrive, makes the weapon easier to use. As for upgrades, pretty much everything is great here, though I might recommend the rapid fire upgrade as you'll get better DPS that way. After that, I'd say it's really a matter of whether you want vent efficiency or emergency cooling, which will depend on your playstyle. If you're good at moderating the cooling, go with vent efficiency, and if you're like me and you kind of suck at that, go with emergency cooling. Again, I think this is the best weapon in the game, and if you want it, it's located at the Shrouded Bolt Arc that's located in the Doom Sea. I'll show the location on the map here, which should help making this thing a bit easier to find. Alright guys, I think that's gonna wrap up this particular video. This video was meant to be an experiment, and like I said for one of my videos from a few months back, I'm going to continue doing some more of these experiments in addition to some of my more regular Borderlands content. But as always, if you enjoyed this video, please be sure to leave a like, click the bell so you can be notified when I upload my next video, and as always, and again, thank you all so much for supporting this channel. Take care, and I'll see you all in the next one.
You better not, you. Everybody want Wick. I ain't no bitch. Wrong way. Look, y'all ain't see that. See, look, I'm trying to edit it one way. I'm trash. Somebody give me edit courses, please. No, what am I doing? This ain't no damn scrims, yo. I can't edit. Give me an edit course, please. Baby G, help me. Oh, look at him. Look at you. Oh, this motherfucker's still alive. I don't normally use the niggas down after that. Hello? RIP! Oh my god! He ain't even had to do that! Hello? Yo, your ankle's okay? I know he got a med kit, but look, I ain't trying to risk it. Damn, my man's ankle's hurting. And kids, look, that's why that gun's, it's not trash. It's just not better than the gun that I got. I'm put it that way. You understand? I'm gonna try to catch this dub for y'all boys. But everybody plans like this. I got them $1 million in the line or something. I ain't had to do all that, but look. You can still use them, T's. I'm gonna catch. I got a 9 kills and there's 6 people left, bro. I'm gonna catch this dub. I mean, you could have still hold it. But where the hell everybody at? What they playing? A $6 million game or something, man? Hell. There's somebody in there. Hey, yo, chill. Chill, yo. I don't want to play like there's $6 million on the line. Look, I don't. If I can get up here, I wish I can get up there. He really wanted to fight me. And this one, the jump gun better. In my honest opinion, I don't care that they nerfed it. Going to storm you. I ain't even a chance at you. Shit, I'm fall off for you, homie. But look, I was gonna help you. But you fucked that up, yo. I never been hooked so hard. Another 14 kill dub, I guess. I'm not sure. Oh, the storm against me. Oh, I can't do math. Hey, yo, my G. Idiot. Let's go 13. Let's get it, baby.